Wesley sanctioned women preachers after being convinced by Mary Bosanquet, later Fletcher, a rich and powerful evangelist who would also have a profound impact on the life of Maria Branwell. It was only after his death that Wesleyans began to backtrack on women leaders. Piety was a theme of Maria's childhood, witnessed by the sampler she completed on the 15th of April, 1791, her 8th birthday, and the month after John Wesley died. Girls of all classes were taught to sew, and the Branwell sisters learned from their mother, showcasing their skill with samplers traditionally completed on their birthday. Maria's was no soothing homily about lilies of the field or lambs, however. She spent the day she turned 8 completing in thread, "Flee from sin as from a serpent, for if thou comest too near to it, it will bite thee. The teeth thereof are as the teeth of a lion to slay the souls of men." Though Wesley's al fresco methods among the working classes irritated conservative high church Anglicans, he remained within the Church of England, and so did Maria's parents. It was, as they say, complicated, and Maria's family was nothing if not ecumenical. In 1807, they helped build a new Jewish synagogue before chipping in for a bigger Methodist chapel. The Carnes had Quaker connections, and Branwells were Freemasons, that not without a mystical dimension. Thomas was also a practical man, renting out one of his houses for Wesley's itinerant evangelists.